Now here is p of x, which is equal to x cube plus ax square minus bx plus 10, is divisible by x square minus 3x plus 2. Find the values of a and b. Consider this. Is 84 divisible by 21? Yes. 84 divided by 21 is 4. Now, how do you factorize 21? 21 can be written as 3 into 7. Now, if 84 is divisible by 21, it also means that 84 is divisible by 3 and 84 is divisible by 7. Correct? If 84 is divisible by 21, 84 is also divisible by the factors of 21, which are 3 and 7, the prime factors 3 and 7. Similarly, if p of x is exactly divisible by this polynomial, then p of x will also be divisible by the factors of this polynomial. Now, why should we factorize this? Because this one is a quadratic polynomial. To apply the remainder theorem, we need linear factors or we need linear polynomials. Hence, we factorize this quadratic polynomial. So, x square minus 3x plus 2, by splitting the middle term, we factorize this and the factors are x minus 2 and x minus 1. So, since p of x is divisible by x square minus 3x plus 2, it means p of x is divisible by x minus 2 and p of x is also divisible by x minus 1. So, let's take up these two cases, case 1 and case 2. Case 1, where p of x is divisible by x minus 2. So, if p of x is divisible by x minus 2, that means the remainder on division will be 0. Divisible meaning exactly divisible. So, the remainder is 0. So, let's apply the remainder theorem. Take up the divisor, x minus 2 is equal to 0, x is equal to 2. If the remainder is 0, how do we represent that symbolically? P of 2 is equal to 0. See, the polynomial is p of x. The dividend is p of x. So, we say p of 2 is equal to 0. 0 meaning this is the value, this is the value, 0 is the value of the polynomial when x is equal to 2. Why is the value 0? Because the remainder is 0. The remainder is 0. The number here represents the remainder. Alright. And why is it? Why is the remainder 0? Because it's exactly divisible. Alright. So we have p of 2 is equal to 0. How do you work on p of 2? In the polynomial p of x, in place of x, replace 2. That's how we have this. And on working this, we get an equation which reads 2a minus b is equal to minus 9. Let we just call that to be the first equation. Take up the second case where p of x is divisible by x minus 1. So again, equate this one to 0. X minus 1 is equal to 0. X is 1. Again, this means when p of x is divided by x minus 1, the remainder is 0. So how we write it symbolically? P of 1 is equal to 0. The remainder is 0. In the polynomial p of x, when we use 1 in place of x, the value will be 0 because this represents the remainder. So p of 1 is equal to 0. So how do you expand p of 1 in the polynomial? In place of x, use 1. So that gives you 1 cube plus a into 1 square minus b into 1 plus 10 is equal to 0. On working this, we have another equation. A minus b is equal to minus 11. So what have we done here and here? We have had the unknowns a and b on one side and the constant on the other side. So here a and b on one side, the constant minus 9 on the other side. Similarly, a and b on one side, the constant minus 11 on the other side. Now we need to solve these two equations and hence find the values of a and b. For which, write up the equations one below the other like this. Write up the equations one below the other. So what are the equations? 2a minus b is equal to minus 9. 2a minus b is equal to minus 9. What's the other one? A minus b is equal to minus 11. A minus b is equal to minus 11. So write out the two equations, one below the other like this. And now, just try to solve it. What is 2a plus a? What is the sign here? Plus 2a plus a. What is plus 2a plus a? Plus 3a. What is this minus b minus b? Minus 2b. Now, the intention here is to get rid of variables a or b. We have two unknowns a and b. We need to get rid of one of them. Either eliminate a. Eliminate a meaning get rid of a or get rid of b. So here it's easy to get rid of b. How? Just change the signs throughout. Change the signs throughout. So this is plus a, make it minus a. This is minus b, make it plus b. See, minus becomes plus. Minus again there becomes plus. Now see what happens. Minus b plus b is 0, which means they get cancelled. So we have got rid of the unknown b or the variable b. Correct? So we have only a left with us. Now we can work this and find the value of a. So our intention was to get rid of one of the variables. So by changing the signs throughout, by changing the signs throughout on the second equation, we got rid of b. Minus b plus b is 0.